The harvest moon is coming, and even if you're tuning into this video too late to see it, well, during the 10 days or so before any full moon, you can observe it around sunset if the clouds permit, and each night you can see how its position changes and how its shape seems to change as it approaches full moon. This year, the harvest moon has two things special about it. The computer program Stellarium is showing us the sky for October 1st, and 20 here means 8 p.m. So it's a little bit after the sun has gone down and the moon has come up a little bit. So there's our harvest moon. Now I want to predict where the harvest moon is going to be the next night. The line here is called the ecliptic, and it shows the path that the sun seems to take against the background of stars as the year goes by, and the moon tracks the same path, roughly. So if the moon is here on the 1st of October, it might move about a hand's width each night. So where's it going to be the next night? Did you guess that the moon would move to this position? What's special about this position is the object right next to it. That's the planet Mars. So the harvest moon is special this year because it's going to be right next to Mars. And you might say, hey, wait, the harvest moon was on the 1st of October. This is the 2nd. Well, I'm going to make the case that you can call this a harvest moon too. The harvest happens in the fall when the crops are ripe. And it's a time traditionally that farmers have a lot of work to do, and it doesn't just last one night. In fact, when it does happen, you might want extra time even after the sun goes down, and the harvest moon provides that light. And it provides that light when the moon is full. It even provides that night the day or two after the moon is full. So here we see the full moon in both positions, as it was on the day it was full on October 1st, and the next day, October 2nd, when it was close to Mars. And during the course of that day, it moved over quite a lot and down a little bit. And that's because the slope of the ecliptic is fairly shallow here. And since it moved down just a little bit, the time it rises will be just a little bit later, well, 24 minutes later than it was on the day it was full, which means you don't have to wait too long after sunset before the moon rises on the day after the full moon, and its light again gives you light for your harvest. So I'm going to say that the moon anytime around the time of full moon could be called a harvest moon. Things are different when the moon is full near the beginning of spring. This year, the full moon closest to the beginning of spring was on April 7th. And when I look at the ecliptic around sundown at that time, it's very steep. And these changes in the steepness of the ecliptic have to do with the tilt of the Earth. So many things have to do with the tilt of the Earth. From the night of April 7th to April 8th, the moon moved over a little bit and down a lot. And since it moved down a lot, after the sun goes down, we're going to have to wait a lot longer for the moon after the full moon to rise. In fact, 75 minutes longer. So if you're working late in spring, well, the full moon will help you. But the day after the full moon, you're going to have a period of darkness before the moon comes up to give you light. The full moon we had near the beginning of spring this year was called a supermoon because that moon happened when the moon was its closest in its orbit to Earth. So it just looked a little bit bigger to us. This harvest moon in the fall is at a time when the moon is farthest from the Earth. So it's looking its smallest to us. And it's not a whole lot smaller than it looked in the springtime, but it's noticeably smaller. I've heard people call that a micro moon, which I think is a little bit of an overstatement since it's still pretty grand looking. So whenever you observe the moon, you can follow its position as it changes, you can follow its shape as it seems to change, and you can follow its size as it appears sometimes a little wider and sometimes a little thinner. And remember, the day after the harvest moon, look at it again and see how close it is to the planet Mars.